Hello everyone, this is Hugh Prem, a legal intern at Lexis & Company and currently pursuing BLLB honors from Central University of South Bihar. In the today's session, I will be dealing with the doctrine of territorial nexus. This topic will further divided in two parts, in two videos, where in the first video, I will be dealing with the meaning of the territorial nexus, the feature of this doctrine. And further in the second video, I will be dealing with the territorial nexus and the state legislature and critical analysis of this doctrine. So, let us start from the introduction part, as the real commission of the offense is not imperative to demonstrate anybody is liable. Anybody can likewise be blameworthy or simple commission or endeavor to commit an offense under section 511 of the IPC. There are three basics for the individual of the offense. The underlying stage is to set up an appropriate outlook for the offense. Furthermore, continuing a stage forward toward the commission of that offense, in conclusion, we neglect to submit that a planned offense. Exception to murder somebody by a vacant weapon is not wrongdoer. However, it is fulfilling all the fundamentals of an endeavor of wrongdoing. Along these lines, this is culpable under 511 section of IPC. There are a few standards for deciding if an act adds. So, under Article 245 of the Indian Constitution, it has been stated that the Parliament has jurisdiction to make laws for extraterritorial operations or laws for the whole or any part of the country. The state legislature has the jurisdiction to make laws for the whole or any part of the state. Thus, it can be said that both the union and the state have their own territorial jurisdiction to make laws. Under Article 246, it has been stated that the Parliament has the implicit power to make laws for the subject matters enumerated in the union list, that is, list 1 of the 7th schedule. The state has the power to make laws for the subject matter enumerated in the state list, that is list 2 of the 7th schedule. Both the state and the union have the power to make laws for the subject matter enumerated in the concurrent list, that is the list 3 of the 7th schedule. Under Article 245 clause 2 of the Indian Constitution, if any law is made by the Parliament regarding the extraterritorial operations, no questions can be raised on its validity. Thus, the validity of a legislation can't be questioned. In this case, a court is bound to enforce the laws made with regards to extraterritorial operations. This regulation can't be invalidated. Now let us see some features of this doctrine. Like the idea of the additional territorial activity of law advanced in India with the silent features of the doctrine. It is settled that the Parliament is enabled to make laws concerning perspectives or causes that happen, emerge or exist, or perhaps expected to do as such. Inside the domain of India and furthermore, regarding extraterritorial angles or causes that have an effect or nexus with India. In Wallis versus Personal Duty Commissioner, Bombay, an organization that was enlisted in England, was an accomplice in a firm in India. The Indian Income Charge authorities looked to the burden, the whole pay made by the organization. The Privacy Chamber applied the doctrine of territorial nexus and held the toll charge substantial. The doctrine of territorial nexus has been applied to the states too, in different cases identifying with Indian with tax collection rules. The courts have on numerous occasions expressed that the deal or buy doesn't have to occur inside the territorial limits of the state. It implies that the item to which the law applies need not be truly situated inside the regional limits of the state, however, should have an adequate territorial association with the state. A state may require a duty on an individual, property, article, or exchange, not just when it is arranged inside its regional cutoff points, yet in addition when it has an adequate and genuine territorial association with it, regardless of whether there is an adequate association is an issue of actually and will be decided by the courts in each as needs be. The doctrine of territorial nexus oversees the tax collection from non-occupants in India. So now let us see the legislative relations between the center and the state. The legislative powers are distributed in two ways, which are provisioned by the Constitution. That is, the distribution of legislative powers in respect of the territory or with respect to the subject matter of the list under 7th schedule. That's all for now. Let us meet in the next session. Hope you like the video. Please do like and subscribe the channel. Thank you.